Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to do a flashback to college statistics, and we are going to go over the standard deviation formula.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I am in Excel, and in my spreadsheet, I have some sales data for each month of the past year in column B. So remember when you learned the phrase standard deviation in your stats class, and you were like, what is that again? Well, I just want to let you know that we have the entire formula for calculating standard deviation out on our blog, and I will include that link below so that you can go to that page and learn more. But basically, in a nutshell, it's a long drawn out formula that takes into account the average or the mean of all of your numbers in a data set. And it does a calculation based on how far each data point is from the mean. And so that sounds really complicated. And if you had to write this formula down on notebook paper and you had to calculate it all out, it would take you a long time. But I just want to show you how easy it is to actually do it in Excel.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So if I click down here in cell B15 and I type equals stdev, I can see that there are a couple different standard deviation formulas right here. And we will go over those nuances a little bit more on our blog entry. But for now, I'm just going to use the standard deviation and do a left parenthesis. And then I'm going to select all of my data points, close my parentheses, and hit enter. And I can see that my standard deviation for my data here is 24. And so that's just a really quick way to calculate it. Hopefully you understand the concepts behind this because you showed up to your stats class and you do understand that the standard deviation does give you a good idea about how well your data is distributed. And this is especially useful when you're looking at different things you are manufacturing or you're looking for variances or how far off something is from a standard that you have set. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.